Acevedo, joining her on the court is her mom, Patricia. Up next is number 40, Ellie Reardon, joined on the court by her mom, Carmel, and her aunt, Marianne. Up next is number 11, Ashley Sullivan, joined on the court by her dad, Mike, and sister Nicole. Up next is number 13, Pamela Gonzalez, joined on the court by her dad, Jose, and Aunt Angela. And now it's time to meet the sign-ups first for the visiting stadiums.
Good evening and welcome to the Tony Cunningham Memorial Gymnasium. We had senior night introducing the seniors. Ellie Reardon, Adrieli Acevedo, Ashley Sullivan, and Pamela Gonzalez for St. Mary's. And they're introducing the starting lineup now. Now they'll introduce the St. Mary's starters. Number 12 is Nicolette Dietria. Number 14, Edgley Acevedo, Ellie Reardon, they're giving the seniors a start. Ashley Sullivan, and the other senior, Pamela Gonzalez, will round out the starting lineup.
Bye.
This is the 2019 Spartan Classic. Has become a yearly event. They have three divisions. They have four teams in each division. Division 1, 2, and 3. The winner of this one will get Amesbury in the Classic Final. These two teams met the first game of the season. St. Mary's got a win. St. Mary's 13-7. Saugus is 13-5. Both of them are going to the tournament. Mark Schurinder is the coach for Saugus. Jeff Newhall, wearing two hats, the AD and the girls' coach. Ellie Reardon will jump. Ellie run, she won the tap, but she knocked it out of bounds, so Saugus will get the ball first. The big play for Saugus is number 14. And that's Alicia Salzillo. She has the basketball. She's a very good player. As she goes, Saugus goes. Straight man-to-man by St. Mary's. They're gonna call a foul. I thought they might call a jump ball. Looked like Sullivan had the basketball. But they hit Sullivan with a foul. And Taylor Bogdansky will get two at the line to try and put Saugus on top. And she does just that. Makes them both. Saugus goes to a three-quarter trap. They almost lost it. From dead in the corner, off the rim, no good. Hit a couple of times. Saugus comes away with the basketball. By Gonzalez, Saugus almost touched it. It's a big game for both teams. It means it could be a plus in the seeding in the tournament. They're both going to the tournament. 15-5 for Saugus could give them a home game. Shot, a wild shot, going out of bounds by Kylie Ronan. St. Mary's trying to get back on the slide. They've lost two in a row. And we're going to get some offense. They've only generated 33 points against Bishop Fenwick. They try to go inside to Ridden and they threw it away. They had nobody to break the ball in bounds. Hillzillo against Dietria. The give and go bounced off a couple of feet. Off the rim, no good. Gonzalez comes away with the rebound. Reardon stuck, they take it away. Zilla with a wild shot, got it to go. She threw up a prayer and it was answered. Hoggis out to a 4-0 lead. They almost lost it again. Gonzalez drop step. Lays it in and gets St. Mary's on the board. Mm-hmm. Short, no good. Gonzalez with the rebound. Has to pull it out. Short is short. Dietria knocked it out of bounds, and we'll get some of what would be the starting lineup for St. Mary's back in, representing those seniors, three of the seniors. Matella, the young eighth grader, Yersi Quiles, and Janice Avellino. Gonzalez takes it away. And he knocked it off Gonzalez's leg. A wild shot, almost got it to go, Bogdanski. Wheelies pushes it up. Her pass is stolen away. Salzillo out in front. Missed the shot. Dietrich made her alter the shot, coming thinking it might be blocked. Big break for St. Mary's there. In and out. Bodies go down, and they're calling it off St. Mary's. So we're almost halfway through this first period, and low scoring, obviously, 4-2 Saugus. Another wild shot by Bogdanski. She get inside, looked like Avellino forced her to alter the shot. Three-point basket by Dietria. And St. Mary's runs five in a row. Stolen away by Quiles. Nice pass. Avellino just bounced it off the rim, couldn't get it to go. Off the rim, no good. And we got a recent foul against Gonzalez. High shot off the backboard. Bogdanski got the rebound. And he called it a non-shooting foul. Dietrich is going out, Gabby Torres is in. Jessica Nazaro is in for Saugus. A wild shot. And they're going to call a foul. Boy, Salzillo, that was a shot that had no chance of going anywhere. It got blocked and went out of bounds. And they hit Gonzalez with their second foul. Doesn't get the bounce on the first one. Missed them both, and they gave it away, but they missed a shot. And now we're going to reach and foul against Salzillo. They missed a shot. St. Mary's had it. They gave it away, and Saugus missed an easy layup. Saugus will now go full court pressure. They get it to Gonzalez. Way cross court. They were lucky to get away with that pass. Acevedo comes out with the rebound. Inside to Gonzalez. Wheelies from dead in the corner, off the rim, no good. Tipped up. Acevedo's had it. Evelino had it. They got a piece of the shot and blocked it. Off the rim, no good. Quigley's on the fly. Follow. Quigley's got knocked down, no call. On the follow, St. Mary's got hit. They'll be at the line. Metella, good hustle following. We'll be at the line for two. Misses the first. Metella gets on the board. It's like a fast pitch softball game. It's 6-4 with coming up on a minute and a half left in the period. Shot clock winding down. A wild left hand hook doesn't hit anything. Saugus taking some strange shots. Metella almost got stuck and she threw it away. .116 left in the first period, 6-4 St. Mary. Saugus scored the first four. They haven't scored since. Stripped away by Quigley's. Coast to coast. Nice job by the eighth grader. Under a minute left. Zelzilla with another wild shot. Had no chance at all to make that shot, but she gets fouled and she'll be back at the line. Boy, Saugus is taking some really horrific shots. She's trying to end an 8-0 run by St. Mary's. She's missed three in a row. Jillian Recupero is in the ballgame for Saugus. She makes one. Way cross court. Torres can't get the shot off. Metella came up short. Jump ball, it'll be St. Mary's basketball. The shot clock is off. If they choose, they can take the last shot. Torres for three, in and out. Long three, no good. Avelino with the rebound. Quick outlet to Metella. Across, nice play. Metella, they doubled up on her and she got it across to Quigley's for the easy layup. At the buzzer, it doesn't go. So Saugus scored the first four points of the game. St. Mary's won an 8-0 run before Salzillo finally hit a free throw. And then the nice play, Metella to Quigley's. They get the last bucket. They get double digits in the first period. At the end of one, with that 10-2 8-1 run by St. Mary's. It's St. Mary's 10, Saugus 5 at the end of one. Saugus with the basketball. St. Mary's with the lead. Avellino got a piece of the arm of Granara. Granara will be at the line for two. Avellino was blocking the baseline. Granara went the other way, got in the paint. And a reach in, cost it a foul. Off the rim, no good. Saugus has missed a few free throws. And they miss another one. Long rebound to Metella. They wind up with the three, and it's good, Metella. Good ball movement, they very patient. Waiting for that 3-point shot. Evelyn is going to get caught for reaching over. Her second foul. And with 7:19 left in the first half, Saugus will be shooting free throws the rest of the way. Although, even the first period, first half actually, it hasn't been a strong point. Almost stolen away by Grossi. She got a fingertip on it. Grossi's in. For Avellino, who picked up her second foul. Stolen away nicely by Nowicki, who just came in. Didn't get the goal, Metella with the rebound. Tip out, back out to Torres. St. Mary's being patient, moving the ball, trying to move that zone. Nice rebound by Grossi. Grossi almost got another one. Torres threw it down, but it came back out again. Picked off by Metella. And she got fouled. Salzilla was up in the air trying to save it. She tipped it back right into the hands of Metella. She went the length of the court. Didn't get the layup to go, but she got bumped. Perfect with that one. St. Mary starts with a 5-0 run. They got the lead up to 10. Saugus will take a timeout. Jeff Newhall is very happy he's got Metella back, being a junior. He's got most of these kids back. Gonzalez is the only starter that's gone. .6:27 left in this first half, the 2019 Spartan Classic. They put this together at the end of the year so they have some games that wouldn't be a long wait between the end of the season and the start of the tournament. And it's been a success. The boys do it as well. Not to the tune of 12 teams as this one is. The boys are a little more compact. But they do it as well to give everybody a couple of games. They fall down, Grossi takes it away. Torres wound up on the floor. So a little helter-skelter that last 30 seconds. Body's hitting the floor. And we're going to get a recent foul, and that's going to put Saugus at the free throw line. Jillian Recupero will get one-on-one. She needs the first to get the second. Dietra and Gonzalez are coming back. Grossi, Quiles, and Metella will stay. They missed another free throw. Nice job by Grossi. Reached up overhead, tipped it back to herself, and saved it. Good job. Inside to Gonzalez. Metella outside. Look inside to Gonzalez. They double, triple. Shot got partially blocked. They couldn't beat the shot clock. Metella tried to get it up to beat the shot clock, and it got tipped. Off the rim, it got the bounce. Salzillo looked like she missed it. It bounced back and went in. They got Salzillo covering Gonzalez. And the pass got tipped away. Saugus gets it back. Three-point bomb. Metella just took it away. Quiles lets it fly for three. We're gonna check her birth certificate, make sure she's an eighth grader. Wild shot. The kick out, Grossi to Dietria. And we got a foul. Dietria will go to the free throw line. I got to tape up Metella's knee. She got bounced and might have a little bit of blood showing. Nicole Gagnon, who does a great job for the Spartans, taping everything up, making sure she's all right to stay on the court. Dietria missed the first. Gets the bounce on the second. Blocked nicely by Dietria. Quiles tried to make the pass, it got blocked. Salzillo throws it in. Three seconds on St. Mary's. Grossi went in there looking for the ball, didn't get it, and she stayed there. .334 left in this first half, 19-10. St. Mary's. Almost stolen away by Dietria. And Gonzalez. Stolen away now by Metella. Trying to go underneath the deep field with the pass. You get in that close, you have to take the shot. She got in very deep, trying to make the pass. Saugus knocked it out. Gonzalez had it stripped away and it goes out of bounds. She beat Salzillo, but there was they double team her every time. Easy pickers for Gonzalez inside. St. Mary's by 11. Long three-point bomb is good. Bogdanski threw that from out in the street. That should have been worth about six. Sullivan came back in. Petrie gets a pick, uses it. Lost, but at the last minute, it got knocked out by Bogdanski. 2.5 left, 21-13, St. Mary's. Inside, nice play with a foul. Avelino got open underneath on a nice pick and roll underneath. Got the layup to go. And she's looking for a three-point play. They put her back in with her two fouls. Off the rim, no good. Tip, and stolen away by Sullivan. Off the rim, no good. Salzillo gets shut off. A tough shot. She was trying to come out from under three different people. Took a very tough shot, obviously didn't make it. Give and go, nice play. Gonzalez come up, set the pick, gave it out, and they gave it back for the easy layup. Dietrich with the nice pass. Off the rim, no good, tip. Saugus gets it back. Biggest lead of the game for St. Mary's, 12. Stolen away by Sullivan. Good hustle by Ronan to knock it away. Torres is coming back. Gonzalez is going out. Out deep to Mattel, almost lost it. Got it before went in the backcourt. They tried the pick and roll, but it wasn't along the baseline. It was in the... Torres. We're going to reach and foul against Saugus, I think. 102 left now. The rest of the half, 102. Both teams will be shooting free throws. Reardon is coming in. Avelino with her two fouls are going out. Salzillo picked up her second foul. Out deep to Dietria. Torres, a long three, knocks it down. That was from out in the street. Turning the ball over, gives it back to the Spartans. The shot clock is off. They can take the last shot if they choose. They saved it, and they're very lucky. They threw it away. Mattel did a nice job of saving it. and got it right to St. Mary's. There was nobody around to pick it up. And now they throw it right into the hands of Saugus. Dietria and Torres combined to block it. 10.6 seconds left. Jeff Newhouse will be very happy with this first half. They got 33 points in the game against Fenwick. Stolen away by Sullivan. That's gonna do it. So their whole song is to 13 points. They got 5 in the first, 8 in the second. St. Mary's has a big 18-point second period. And St. Mary's getting off the slide a little bit offensively. That 6 different people have scored. At the end of the half, at St. Mary's 28, Saugus 13. Tony Conigliaro Memorial Gymnasium. This is the 14th annual Spartan Classic. Originally from 2006 to 2009, it was Division 1 and 2 only. St. Mary's won the very first in Division 2. They won 2 out of 4 in Division 2. Then they expanded it. Division 1, 2, and 3. St. Mary's has won 7 out of 9. So in the last 13, St. Mary's has won 7. Really short missed. So they're looking for their 8th Spartan Classic championship. Getting loose inside was Bogdanski. So I guess gets on the board first. Saugus led 4-0. St. Mary's scored 10 in a row, 8 in a row. Wound up. Dietria, lefty high off the glass. He scored 8 in a row, and they actually outscored Saugus 10-1 over the final after Saugus took that 4-0 lead, and it was 10-5 at the end of one. St. Mary's opened up with a 5-0 run to get it into double digits and continued on to make it 18-8 in that second period. And that increased the lead. To 28-13. They've matched baskets, but now Granada gets her first point. Saugus only had 2 scorers in the first half. Bogdanski got 5, Chalzillo got 8. And now it makes 2. Full court pressure by Saugus. Metella gets it to Quiles. Quiles, Metella, Gonzalez. Grossi just came in for Avellino, picked up her 3rd foul. And Dietria. Dietria going to the basket, had it down around knee high when they got a piece of it and knocked it out. Dietria outside. Metella gets a pick, stops, takes the shot off the rim, no good. Bogdanski. Salzillo can't get the shot off. They did a pretty good job on Salzillo. She only had 2 points in the first period. Long 3-point bomb. Gonzalez. That was Marissa Stockwell with that long 3-point bomb. Wheelies had 7. Metella, Gonzalez had 6 apiece. 6 different scores for St. Mary's. So they picked up the offense. We mentioned before, the winner of this will get Amesbury in the classic final. Salzillo brings it up against Etria. Left-handed hook doesn't go. Grassi with the kick out. Down court, Quiles. Nice pass. Quiles knocks it home. And a blocking foul against Metella. She didn't get herself set along the baseline and forced Granada to step out of bounds. She kind of reached in a little bit and tried to block her with her body. And she picked up the foul, her first. Off the rim, no good. Metella with the rebound to Gonzalez. She gives it to Quiles to bring up. Patella from the corner, no good. Gonzalez grabs the rebound. Stolen away. Salzillo lost it, fell down. Saugus looking for a foul, they don't get it. 3-point shot by Metella. Her second. And the biggest lead of the game for St. Mary, 17. First foul on Quiles. Still hard to believe she's an eighth grader. Three-point basket by Salzillo. We told you, she's a very good player. Petrie was short. Gonzalez right there for the easy pickings. She's got 10. They got two others with 9. Three-point bomb, no good. Deep down court, Gonzalez has to pull it out. Deepia down the lane, blocked nicely by Bodansky, knocking it out of bounds. Saugus staying a little bit closer in this period. 11 to 10 St. Mary's, but that big 15-point lead at halftime. Saugus has got almost as many points in this period with 3:47 left as they did in the first half. He got a couple other people on the board. Stockwell got a three. Granada got a couple of free throws. But they only have two people with more than one basket. St. Mary's has Quiles with 9, Metella with 9, Gonzalez with 10. St. Mary's with the basketball. Inside to Gonzalez. Missed the layup. Bernardo brings it up. Almost thrown away. Quealy's anticipated the pass. Stepped in front, but couldn't control it, went out of bounds. Silzillo. They kick it out. Shot clock winding down. They have to get it up. Missed everything. Wrap around is good. From under the basket, Granara. With the shot clock winding down. No good. Dietrich racks down her own rebound. Off the rim, no good. Tipped again. Salzillo. Stolen away. Willis pulls it back out. Metella gets a screen. Can't hit it. Knocked out by Gonzalez. Avellino and Torres are coming back. Rossi and Dietrich go out. So Metella, Gonzalez, and Quealy stay in. 39-25 St. Mary's. Saugus led briefly 4-0. St. Mary's won an 8-0 run. Kicked out of bounds by Shalzillo. Torres did a nice job going over the top and knocking that pass away. And then Shalzillo knocked it out of bounds. They'll give it to Quealy's. As we're coming up on 2 minutes left in this third period. Torres fakes the shot and gets hit as she goes to the basket. She spends more time on the floor than she does standing up. She got knocked down again. She'll get two at the line. That's the third foul on Salzillo. Two at the line for Gabby Torres. Perfect. Stolen away by Quealy's, but she stepped out of bounds. Nice defense. Gonzalez is going out. We're seeing Nowicki's coming in. She's had a up and down season. Nowicki was hurt. She was out for a while, came back, had to sit again for a while. Now she's back again. She's a very good softball player. As St. Mary's knocks it out of bounds. Outfielder pitcher. Her sister was it. The ace of the staff. Almost stolen away. Wild shot. Blocked nicely by Avellino and taken away. Tipped up again. Salzillo takes it away. Off the rim, no good. Avellino, head and shoulders. We got a reach and foul. Nowicki was going to give it up to Metella. It'll be a non-shooting foul. Only the second team foul. 1:20 left in the period. St. Mary's has added a point to that 15-point halftime lead. Torres got loose but couldn't take the shot. Torres hits the floor again. Off the rim and out by Metella. A minute and counting. Long three-point bomb off the rim, no good. Here we got a foul on the floor against St. Mary's. Second foul on Torres. Metella goes out. What a wild shot by Salzillo. She got stuck, she couldn't get a shot off. She ducked away and threw up a left-handed hook. She's desperate to get shots off. They've shut her down. She's got 11 points, but boy, they're tough 11 points, and she's taking some really strange shots. Out of bounds, they missed the shot. Avellino fights for the rebound. The tie-up, it'll be Saugus with the alternate possession getting the basketball. And on the pass in, we got a foul. That'll be the limit for St. Mary's. Saugus will be shooting free throws the rest of the game. Shot is shot, another air ball. Wheelie's almost lost it. Inside to Avellino. Off the rim, no good. Gets her own rebound, gets fouled. And if that's Salzillo, it's four. It is on Salzillo, and that's her fourth foul. Off the rim, no good.
What do you got, an arm guard?
Avellino makes that one. Salzillo is staying in with her four fouls. A wild shot almost went around the rim and out. And we got a foul against Saugus. Second foul on Recupero. 0.7 seconds, they probably won't get a shot off. And they don't. So they add a couple of points. They're up 15 at halftime. They're up 17 at the end of three. St. Mary's 42. Saugus 25 at the end of three. 8 minutes of basketball left. St. Mary's by 17. Again, Jeff Newhall's got to be happy over the offense picking it up. Torres looking to go to the basket. Comes up short. Salzillo was out of the ballgame with her four fouls. Torres back on the floor. Saugus saves it, but right to Nowicki. Inside to Avellino, they kick it out to Sullivan. Nowicki. Too strong with the shot. Bodies go down all over the place. Saugus lost two. Sullivan went down as well. No call. Had to be something. Offense, defense, had to be something. Saugus wanted to charge. St. Mary's wanted to block. Three people hit the floor. Long rebound to Torres. Defense. Nowicki didn't take the shot. Torres will. In and out. Off to him, no good. Follow. Perfect position for Recupero. She was out of the basket. The ball hit the rim and didn't bounce. It just died on the rim and fell right into her lap, and she had the easy layup. Her first basket. And Saugus gets on the board first here in the fourth period. Both teams looking for their 14th win. Shamiri's plays a couple more. They play 22. Saugus plays 20. The winner of this gets Amesbury in the Classic Final. The loser plays tomorrow afternoon against Bedford in the consolation round of the Classic. .611 left in this one. Patella, Torres, Dietria, Gonzalez, Avellino. Saugus going full court pressure. They lob it over the top. Saugus knocks it out. Defeat to Metella. Gonzalez. Strong to the basket. She took steps. A little late. She did take steps, but a little late whistle. Salzilla was back in the ballgame with her four fouls. Off the foot, it goes to the floor. We're gonna tie up. Saugus called the timeout while the ball was on the floor, thinking they might lose it. Saugus only has one timeout left. 5:47 left in this one. St. Mary's winning this one will look for their 10th championship out of the 14. And that's winning. There have been a few others. They'll be looking to make it 6 out of 7 in this Division III. Gazilla shot, no good. Boy, she's having a tough time. And Mary's pushing it up. Torres, strong and too strong. She called for a charge. Quiles is going to replace Torres as she picked up her third foul. Elzillo with an open lane right to the foul line. Can't hit it. Ball goes to the floor. It'll be a jump ball. Saugus will get it. Hook's not going to go, but they got a foul, I think, before the shot. They're going to be at the foul line anyway for 1-on-1. St. Mary's is over the limit. Granada, 2 for 2 from the line, is back there now. Got the bounce. So she'll get the bonus. Knocked that one down clean. She's 4 for 4. Wheelie's behind the back, beating everybody. They try to go over the top to Avelino. They threw it too far. Telzula got away with a travel. Another wild shot by Telzula. She'll be at the line for a couple. And the rest, 5:08, the rest of the game, Saugus will be shooting 2. Rossi is back. Avelino goes out. Zillow makes them both. A 6-0 run here in jump ball will be Saint Mary's basketball. They took it away from Gonzalez, but they tied it up. Saint Mary's will get the basketball. The lead is down to 11. With almost just about 5 minutes left. Rossi wide open. Nice pass. They ran a little screen. Nice move by Bodansky, and it went around the rim and out. Gonzalez drops it in. So just like that, the lead is back up to 15. Off the rim, no good. Rossi with a big rebound. St. Mary's looking to run. Metella, off the rim, no good. Long rebound, tip from Metella. Saugus looking for a foul. Metella ran right over. Inside, what a great pass by Gonzalez. But Rossi gave it to her, Gonzalez gave it back, and just like that, the lead is back up to 17. Metella ran right over Stockwell. So I guess, how come that's not a foul? Gonzalez with the rebound. They kick out, St. Mary's running again. Metella's gonna get knocked down. And they're calling Metella for a charge. Little out of control. Her second. Nice drive to the basket. That was a good shot by Salzillo. Off the hand of Grossi, but they're going to get Stockwell for a hand in the back. No one shooting foul. Van Nguyen is coming in the ball game for the first time. Nguyen is the one with two different color shoes. They try to go over the top, but they threw it too far. And it was tipped by Saugus trying to save it. I'm not sure why. They go out deep. Wheelie says they go get it. It's not a backcourt violation. Gonzalez from dead in the corner, no good. Salzillo on the fly. Can't get the shot off. High arcing shot, doesn't hit anything. Saved by Saugus, but right to Dietria. Gonzalez strong to the basket, lays it in. on the drive, Stockwell gets fouled. She'll get two at the line. Doesn't make a difference if it was a shooting foul or not. St. Mary's in double penalty. Stockwell gets that one. Ellie Reardon is back in the ball game. That one is no good. Gonzalez with the rebound. I think Jeff Newell will try to get his seniors in at the end here. Three-second call against St. Mary's. Strong drive to the basket by Bodansky. Came up short, but she came up short because she got bumped by Ellie Reardon. She'll get two at the line. Ten of their 35 points have come from the free throw line, Saugus. Make it 11 if she makes both. Yeah, we got a timeout. 2:06 left in a basketball game. St. Mary's gonna pick up their 14th win. Saugus will drop to 13-6. It'll be St. Mary's and Amesbury in the classic final. It'll be Saugus and Bedford in the consolation. And nice to see St. Mary's getting back some of their offense and getting off the slide a little bit. They're still looking to try and get a home game. They gave it away. Millerick lays it in. Nguyen turned it over. Ridden's going to get called for the foul. Saugus back at the free throw line. Gonara is 4-for-4. And I jinxed her. She missed her first. She makes one. No. St. Mary's by 11. They clear out, let Gonzalez bring it up. Three-point shot by Quilish. Tough shot again by Salzillo. Gonzalez with the rebound. Goes to the floor. St. Mary's called a timeout. While Gonzalez had the ball on the floor. 105 left in the game. St. Mary's by 14. We're going to get the seniors on the floor. Ajale Acevedo. Ellie Reardon. Ashley Sullivan. And Pamela Gonzalez. The seniors, 105 left. Saugus picked up a little bit in the second half. They doubled their output in the second half. They only got 13 in the first half. 5 in the first period after jumping out to a 4-0 lead. They led 4-0. St. Mary's went on an 8-0 run. Finished the period 10-1 to lead 10-5. And it was downhill for Saugus after that. The lead got as high as 17 a couple of times. St. Mary started the second period with a 5-0 run to put in the double digits. 18-8 for the period, made it 28-13, a 15-point difference. They added two more in the third. They go up 17. Saugus got as close as 11. And we got a reach-in foul against Saugus. And now it'll be everybody shooting free throws. Wheelies is still out there. And they tie up the ball. It'll be St. Mary's basketball. Nice pass to Gonzalez, couldn't hit the shot. She's gonna get two shots at the line. She went right by the defense, couldn't get the layup to go. She's got a chance for two. Saugus will put a lot of backups in. Gets the bounce, she's gonna come out, I think. She's gonna go to the bench. Abby Kornstein will take her place. Ridden's out there. Acevedo's out there. PJ Parent is out there as well. And Pascal's off the fingertip. Sullivan, the other senior, is out there. I think they're going to be taking the seniors out one at a time. Sullivan will go to the bench. As Manthorn comes in. Shot clock is off. The reach in foul is going to put PJ Parent at the free throw line. In and out. stolen away by St. Mary's. Saugus steals it back. Now St. Mary's steals it back. Off the glass, no good. Off the rim, no good. That's going to do it. So St. Mary's gets their offense back on senior night. They make senior night a successful night. They put 55 on the board. As I mentioned before, Saugus led once. They got first 4 points. They led 4-0. St. Mary's went on 8-0 run, extended it to 10-1 to open up a 10-5 lead at the end of one. 5-0 run in the second period, got it up to double digits. It finished off at 18-8 to push the lead to 15 points. It got up to 17 points a couple of times. It ended up 16, 55-39 St. Mary's. Salzillo had 15 points, but they were very hard 15 points. She took some really tough shots, had to really work for her 15 points. For St. Mary's, Avellino had 3, Torres had 5, Grossi played very well, had 4, Dietria had 6, Metella had 9, the young eighth grader, Yersi Quiles, had 12, and Pamela Gonzalez led the way with 16. So I just cut it down as close as 11 in the fourth period, but St. Mary's built it back up, and they were able to play those 4 seniors and get them some playing time here on senior night. And they helped Saugus off. St. Mary's is going to go to 14-7. Saugus will drop to 13-6. The final score, St. Mary's 55, Saugus 39. We hope you enjoyed it. I'm John Hoffman saying we'll see you next time.